the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Abba Father. My sisters and brothers in Jesus Christ, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. My brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, right now we pray that the Holy Spirit will guide us, strengthen us, heal us, and unite our family by the power of the heavenly anointing you are going to receive right now as we listen the word of God. My sisters and brothers in Jesus Christ, the first letter of St. Peter, chapter 5, verse 7. Cast all your anxieties on him, for he cares about you. The word of God would teach us, cast all your anxieties on him, for he cares about you. The question is, cast all our anxieties on whom? On Jesus Christ. That is something so amazing. We have a God who listens to us, who hears every word, every movement of our life. He understands. And God, the word of God would say, cast all your anxieties on him, for he cares about you. My sisters and brothers in Jesus Christ, let us think about our life and the people around us. If you ask a person, are you okay? The same person would tell you, everything is okay, but at the same time, something is wrong. Something is going on that disturbs me so much. Do just think about your life. What about you? Are you okay? Yes, it's okay. At the same time, something disturbs you. If you ask the same question to a child, the same child would say, it's okay, but something is there that disturbs me so much. If you ask the same question to an old person, the same answer will be there. It's okay, but something is there. What is this something? That is what we call the anxiety of our life. My sisters and brothers, God understands that anxiety is there inside your mind. And today, God would say, cast all your anxieties on Jesus Christ. You have a God, and whatever the anxiety is there in your mind, you cast it out, cast this anxiety into the loving hands of our Lord Jesus Christ. My sisters and brothers, since this anxiety, it's a fundamental problem for all the people in the universe. So what to do? Everyone should understand one thing. The anxiety is just like a dot. When it begins, it's just like a dot. And when you allow that anxiety to develop deep within you, then what happens, you know, it can turn into something so difficult a thing in your life that will disturb your life so much. If it begins with a dot, and if you allow that anxiety to develop in you, it will spread like a cancer, and that can cause your death even. Okay, let us come back to the Holy Gospel. And the Gospel of Saint Matthew, we find Jesus and the disciples in the sea, in the boat. And what happened, you know, quickly the storm came, such a big storm. And Peter, the moment the storm came in, the such a mighty wind, what happened? An anxiety developed at the heart of Peter. And Peter thought that, okay, I can manage that. This is the mistake that you and I do in our life. When there is an anxiety, when there is a dot of anxiety, we think with our intellect that I'm able to manage this. I can do something over that, and I can conquer that. In fact, that may not happen most of the cases. What happened? Peter said, okay, I can do something. Yes, of course, he can do many things and concerning that anxiety, because he's a fisherman. He knows the storm. He knows the sea. He knows how to do that thing. Even he knows how to swim even. But that is not enough in certain cases, my sisters and brothers. You see, Saint Peter, this great man, what happened? He said, yes, I shall try. Peter said, yes, let it come, I will do. But there came a moment he was not able to do anything. The moment he understood that he is perishing, he called Jesus. The moment he understood that he is perishing, now the question is, where were he? He was there, the same boat, same sea. Jesus was also there. He called Jesus, don't you know that we are perishing? When did he call Jesus? The moment he's about to perish, the moment he's about to die. Now, the same thing is happening in your life. When you lost your job, you understood, yes, there is an anxiety, I can manage it. When you got a disease, you thought that I can manage it. When there is a problem in your family life, there is an anxiety, you thought that you can control that. Then when there is a problem in your children's life, you thought that it's not such a big thing. I know what to do and I will do that, and you did it. But today, the things gone so much higher and higher, and now you are not able to control that or manage that. What to do? No idea at all. Saint Peter, what did he do? He called Jesus. Sisters and brothers, if you allow any anxiety to develop in your mind, that becomes a cancer and that can cause even the death. And what happened? Peter called Jesus. Jesus, don't you see that we are perishing? Don't you see that we are perishing? So what to do? Don't allow any anxiety to develop in your mind. The moment it is developed, the moment it is there in your mind, you just give it to word, Jesus Christ. The Word of God would teach us, cast all your anxieties on Him. No exception. All the anxiety, maybe small, maybe medium, maybe bigger, whatever it may be, the anxiety, cast all the anxieties on Jesus, because He cares about you. That is the important thing. He cares about you. See, in the sea, Jesus responded very quickly, saying, "Don't you have faith? Don't you have faith? Don't you know that I am with you? In your anxiety, don't you know that I am with you?" Today, in your struggle and difficulty, Jesus Christ is asking the same question, that don't you know, my daughter, my son, that I am with you? I am with you. So Jesus is with you today. So cast all the anxieties on Him. If you feel that the burden is so high and you are not able to do anything right now, please surrender that burden into the loving hands of God. God cares for you. God loves you. God has a special concern over your life. My sisters and brothers, think about our life. We often, what we do when we have an anxiety, we surrender that anxiety calling somebody. Your best friend or your family friend or somebody, you know that person is able to manage that situation, but that person can help you to a great extent, but at the same time, ultimately, only God can heal you. God can manage that situation. The anxiety, only God can take it away from your life. See the Word of God, St. Matthew chapter 6, verses 26. "Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they?" So God is telling again, "And which of you, by being anxious, can add one cubit to his span of life?" You can't do nothing. You can't do nothing in certain cases. You will be just standing there at the crossroads of your life, just standing, helpless, hopeless, distressed, and completely gone, disappointed. Sisters and brothers, you can do nothing. You will not be able to take even a single step. What to do? You stand there, call your name, call the name of your God. Jesus Christ, come. That's what the book of Revelation would teach us. Maranatha, Lord, come, Lord, come, Lord, come. So without God, nothing is going to work. Some people, what happens, you know, in their anxious mind, anxiety, they try on some kinds of objects, maybe alcohol, maybe cigarette, maybe drugs. Today, the young people, have you ever thought, why do they do that? Why are they addicted to drugs or alcohol? The thing it is that it's a kind of escapism. I speak with many young people and they would say, especially during the youth retreat, they say it's a kind of escapism. They find nobody to help, and they say if they're addicted to any kinds of drugs, the drug can control them. That's what I say. Actually, it's not that way. In fact, they are moving from deeper to deeper to deeper level of anxiety. They just spoil the life, and after that they come saying, "Jesus, we need your help." Ultimately, Jesus is your answer. So whatever may be the struggle, the problem you have today, you pray to Jesus, "Lord, I surrender." The alcohol or the drink or the drug, it cannot be a solution for the problem and the anxiety you have today. If you have the brokenness in your mind, you will be more anxious because there is no way to come out of that because already you are broken, already you are crushed. So what to do? Only one thing, let the healer come, surrender the brokenness and the anxiety into his loving hands. The healing touch, the hand which has got the healing power must touch you. That is more important. See, a leper came. He had the anxiety when he meets a young person or the Jewish person. The Jewish person will tell, "Go away, go away, go away." What is the reason? If a Jewish person touches a leper, he will be defiled. So they don't prefer that. So he is really rejected. In that rejectedness, he had the anxiety. Where to go? No way. With whom shall speak? No idea. So there is only one. They had only one person with whom he can speak very well. There is only one person in his life he can touch the person. Who is that? Only Jesus Christ. Everyone in the universe, they are beyond his limit. Jesus is the only person, approachable person. I would say approachable God in the universe. You can touch him. You can feel him. You can understand the real love from him. So cast the anxiety on him. That's what the leper asked Jesus. Jesus, if you will, you can touch me and make me heal. What does it mean? I surrender my anxiety. I surrender, Lord. Please touch me. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Worship you, Jesus. Think about the wedding feast at Cana. There are many people, especially one person, Mother Mary, cast the anxiety into the hands of loving Jesus Christ. She knows that this is the only person, the person can take away the anxiety of the whole society, the whole wedding feast. What happened? Jesus touched the 5 empty vessels. And what happened? The empty vessels, it became vessel of anointing. My brother and sister in Jesus Christ, understand one thing, let Jesus touch you. The anxiety, you say nobody to help you. No, it's not truth. That is absolutely a lie which the Satan has taught you. You have to come out of that. Let Jesus touch you. You go to Jesus and feel his presence. I tell you, with this anxiety, what are you going to do? You just go from worse, from bad habit, again to worse, then the worst. So don't do that. What you have to do is blindly trust in the power of the Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ will touch you, touch your family. And when Jesus touches, there begins the big celebration. Think about the wedding feast at Cana. There begins the great celebration. Don't you think that you will have a celebration in your life? Or you think that you have to be like a distressed person, completely lost person forever? Don't think like that. You need to begin a celebration. If you need a celebration, cast the anxieties into the loving hand of Jesus. Let the hand of Jesus touch your life and the anxiety, let it move away from your life forever and ever. Again, I want to introduce another family in the Holy Bible, the family of Martha and Mary. Actually, what happened there, sister and brother? The Martha, the two sisters, they were anxious about the only brother. Name is Lazarus. He's dead and he's inside the tomb. Actually, what happened, you know, there is nobody to help them. And the Lazarus, the only brother, already dead. What to do? They send somebody to Jesus saying, your friend Lazarus is ill. That time he's not dead. Even then Jesus said, I'm coming. What happened? Lazarus is dead. After a few days, Jesus came. Again, they had the anxiety. After the anxiety said, Jesus, if you had come earlier, my brother would not have died. That is the response. From that very response itself, you can understand the anxiety about their future. Now we have no brother. He is dead. Jesus, it is so painful. That's what they said. The anxiety they surrendered. Jesus said, if you believe, you will see a miracle. The glory of God. My sister, my brother in Jesus Christ, what you have to see is the glory of Jesus amidst of all the anxieties of life. Why don't you think about the glory of Lord? There is a day coming, the glory of God will rest upon you. This is the promise of God. God has given to all the generations, especially to the people of Israel, 40 years of wilderness. God of Yahweh said, you will see the glory of God. What they have seen every day, the clouds, they have seen the glory of God. Daytime, they have seen the glory of God. When they got the manna, they have seen the glory of God. If the history teaches that the glory of God will shine over all the people, then why the same glory will not shine over your life, over your family's life? It will shine. What to do? Don't try to solve all the issues by yourself. That's a great blunder that you're trying to do. Many people tried in the history and they have become miserable failures in the life. It should not be repeated in your life. What you have to do, you just look at the face of Jesus, cast all your anxieties on him. Let the touch of Jesus make everything so positive, so anointed. Like Martha and Mary, you also have to see the glory of God in your life. And that glory will be so wonderful, so amazing, so anointed. So whatever may be the glory, whatever may be the tension, anxiety, you just surrender into the hand of loving Lord. You know, my sisters and brothers, the word of God would teach us how God is gracious to us, how God wants to anoint us. Book of Psalms, Chapter 115, verses 12. The Lord has been mindful of us. See that word of God? The Lord has been mindful of us. He will bless us. He will bless us in the sense, in your anxiety, God will take that anxiety away and he will bless you. Whatever needed in your life, God understands more than you. God will bless you. You surrender that and pray. And after the prayer, you will find something so wonderful, my sister, brother. You must see that. The Lord will bless us. He will bless the house of Israel, the whole territory receiving anointing from God. He will bless the house of Aaron. He will bless those who fear the Lord, both small and great. Both small and great. God will bless every one of us. God will anoint every one of us. What do you have to do? In your anxiety, you have to pray this prayer like the psalmist would pray. Psalms chapter 69, verses 13. But as for me, my prayer is to you, O Lord, at an acceptable time. O God, in the abundance of your mercy, answer me. What is the prayer? See that prayer. At an acceptable time. Acceptable time. God has a time. So if you're anxious about your life, what is the use of that? God has an acceptable time. You just surrender like this. But as for me, my prayer is to you, O Lord. This is my prayer, Jesus. What is my prayer? At an acceptable time, O God, in the abundance of your mercy, answer me, Lord. That must be your prayer in anxiety. Lord, answer me. Lord, answer me. Lord, bless me. Whatever may be the anxiety, you come back. Anxiety and the life, it matters much. The relation between the anxiety and your future, it is so deep. Because if you are anxious, you will be helpless. The future is empty. So what to do? If you give the anxiety into the loving hands of God, the future is not empty. That much at least you can believe. Because when God touches, there begins the anointing. There begins the resurrection which Lazarus had. God said, Lazarus, come back. Come out of the tomb. There begins the resurrection. So anxiety and future, it is related. So if you have the anxiety, the future is empty. If you give the anxiety to Jesus, there begins the resurrection. The future is not empty. The future is filled with the glory of Jesus. So today, take the rosary, ask the intercession of Mother Mary, pray with Mother Mary, Jesus, bless me as you have blessed the wedding feast of Cana. There I could see the anointing of the of Jesus, the glory of Jesus. So the same anointing I also have to experience in my life. Think about the prodigal son. He had all the possible ways to have the anxiety in his life because, you see, he's a Jewish person and he slept with animal, with pigs. So diametrically opposite, the Jewish person should never touch a pig. So he is staying there. So it's something so negative. He should never do that. Again, he asked from the father, I need the wealth. I need the portion of my wealth. If a father is living, he should never ask from the father the portion of the wealth. That was so bad. So what happened? The father said, yes, I shall give you. What does it mean? You know, I just consider you as though you are dead. I just think that you are dead. That's what he said. And all the wealth he destroyed completely. So three great sins that he has done. Even then, there was no way to come back. He said, I cast all the anxieties into my loving father's hand. I know my father. And he went back. Amidst of all the anxiety, he went and stood before his father. Sisters and brothers, whoever you are, maybe the sinner, the worst sinner in the universe, maybe you have destroyed everything in your family, maybe you are something so bad concerning the society, I tell you, you must have the courage to come back to your father and stand before him saying, Father, this is my anxiety and I surrender. Please understand one thing, the father of the prodigal son did not say anything about his fast, anything about his bad habits, just said, my son, I will protect you. See, even his own brother wants to tell that just leave this person aside. But the father said, I am going to protect my son. My sister, my brother, if you have the courage to cast all the anxieties into the hand of Jesus, Jesus will protect you. That must be the faith you need to have. The word of God would say, St. Mark chapter 13, verses 11. And when they bring you to trial and deliver you up, do not be anxious beforehand about what you are to say, but say whatever is given to you in that hour, for it is not you who speak, but the Holy Spirit. Jesus is giving strength to the disciples. The Holy Spirit will speak when the last moment. If you are about to die, don't worry about it. You speak out, the Holy Spirit will speak. Even the last moment, God can work miracle through Holy Spirit. Let the Holy Spirit guide you. Cast all the anxieties into the hand of God. 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 7. Cast all the anxieties on him, for he cares about you. Today, if you are distressed, if you are disappointed, if you are hopeless, come to Jesus Christ, the living God, the loving God. Made a plan for you, a wonderful plan for you. God will bless you. God will bless your family. That is going to be an amazing grace that will follow you throughout the lifespan. Be take courage. God is with you. God bless each one of you so much. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.